Are you sick of your craptastic webcam quality? I hear you, and I'm here for you. I 100% know that feeling of looking at the little sensor on your webcam and just knowing that the quality is not good. In this video, I'm gonna show you three ways that you can level up your webcam quality: a beginner, intermediate, and advanced. Because I feel like we all watch a lot of news in the very recent history, and first of all, I gotta say I'm super relieved once they called it, because I was just like, now somebody can breathe. Isn't it funny when you're looking at the studio quality of the camera and then you talk to a political correspondent who has all the amazing things to say, but you see them reporting in with their crappy webcam quality and you just can't help but think, ooh,
like, it doesn't look professional. It doesn't look good.
But then every once in a while you see somebody and you're like, ooh, okay, I know they're in their living room, but something looks different. This is the ticket. There are multiple ways to level up your webcam quality, because the truth is the camera in your webcam is never gonna be great. It's always gonna be grainy. I've created lots of videos on how to level up using lighting and things like that, but this one I want to be on what you can do instead of using the webcam itself to level up the quality in general. And the first one is for free. And if we're just meeting, hi, I'm Gia Goodrich. I am a photographer and director by trade, but I love creating tutorials here on YouTube to help people like yourself look good in Zoom, on camera, in video, and to feel confident when you show up. Because the truth is, our lives right now are all happening across digital platforms. And if you can figure out how to level up the quality and walk into that digital space feeling like a champ, then why wouldn't you do that? And really quickly, before we get any further into the video, I have to ask you a favor. If in watching this video, you feel like it's resonating, you're digging the vibes, you're digging the information, will you do me the favor of liking, commenting, and even better yet, sharing this video? If you do so, it really helps support me and my channel and helps my videos get seen. I'm here to take your video quality from rough to respectable, and from respectable to...
what's another R word?
Resplendent. Yes, I'm gonna do that for you. First, to get started, let's talk a little bit about why your webcam is suboptimal. Those cameras in your computer don't have what's called a dynamic range. That means that it has a hard time telling the brightest spots in the frame from the darkest spots. So if whenever you've been on video, you've seen that the exposure changes, how bright it is changes, or maybe you're wearing like a black top and you can see it kind of finding things, sometimes you're super bright, super dark, that's because the quality of your inherent webcam, even if you have a really new laptop, is like at least 10 years behind every other camera on the market, pretty much. So webcams as a category, even the ones you buy externally, still tend to be of that subpar quality. I'm not exactly sure why, but every other camera in video is just making monumental, amazing leaps forward. And it feels like for some reason, the webcam category just like has not caught up. There is one exception that we're gonna talk about. All right, option number one, if you wanna level up your video quality, but you don't wanna spend any money and you have a smartphone, this option's for you. Oh, let's get into Zoom. How about we do that? Yeah, let's do it. Zoom, please. All right, so let's talk about native webcams. We are in my webcam and I have a MacBook Air from 2019. Even though this is a very expensive laptop, you can see the quality is just not good. I don't look sharp. Everything looks grainy and pixelated. And this is even with a really great lighting setup. And of course, it's just because the quality isn't really there. That's not their priority. They have all sorts of other stuff going on. But this first option is using your phone and an app. I just need to say, pardon my tabs, I have ADHD and this is the only way to keep my brain sort of organized so I don't forget where I was, because if I get interrupted, it's a non-starter. A lot of times I won't get back to doing the thing I'm supposed to be doing. Top of mind, tip of tongue, keep going. Searching in Google, you're gonna type in camo webcam. And this first one that comes up, Reincubate, is what we want. You can get Camo Pro for $39.99, but you can also download the free edition. So you click download, downloads there, go through the whole install. Let's do that. Mm-mm-mm. And Camo Studio, and then you just drag it to the app. Boom, boom. And I'm going to stop that because I already have it in there. Now that we have it, I'm just gonna press Command Space and type in Camo. And double click on it. When you first open it, it's going to say no devices connected. This is because you actually have to download the app also on your phone and have them both up and connected at the same time. So we're gonna do this similarly on our phone. So we go to the App Store and type in Camo webcam. Oops, although spelling is helpful. And we get the same thing, Reincubate Camo. Go through the whole installation process. Now I have this installed. So now I have it up on my phone and I also have it up on my computer. The next thing I need to do is just connect my phone with the charging cable that it comes with. So let's find it. Now that we have our charging cable, let's get her done. Plugging it in. And once I plug it in, you'll see that it activates. Now you'll see what my phone is seeing. The important thing to know is you're going to use the rear facing camera. This is what we're gonna use as our webcam. Now what you want is to have it the same place close to your laptop. I actually got this recently, and as you can see, it's just a phone holder. It has a gooseneck, which means you can rotate it in all these different angles. And then it has this little twisty situation so that you can close it down. Then what I'm gonna do is just attach it. So I'm just gonna put it right behind my laptop. So now I have it anchored right in front, and I'm gonna plug my phone in. Right there. Now, I always forget that it's like a little to the side, so I'm gonna try to slide this over a little bit. There we go. So the phone is actually centered toward me. What it comes with are these different options, like you can zoom in and out. So this is seeing my full area. And then I think with the pro version, you can make these adjustments, 1080p, wide lens, white balance, all that stuff. I'm just gonna leave all of that there because I don't need it right now. After we've installed it, we close Zoom all the way. Then we open it back up, log in, start a new meeting, and now this camo comes up. If we look now, this was my internal webcam, and then now this is me using camo and my phone. Now I can go back into my settings and I can adjust because you can see it's a little more blue here. If I want to adjust that, all I have to do is go back into camo and up the exposure just a bit. Look at white balance. Here we go. And warm it up just a bit. Now doing both of those things, we come back into here and now some of that blueness is gone. Now you can tell like right here, the angle's off a little bit. So all I have to do is take my gooseneck and just angle it to where I want it. And I'm looking good. This is a really great solution if you don't want to spend any money, but you want to just up that video quality. I even talked to the people who are the creators of Camo. It's like a wife and a husband and they're lovely and wonderful. They gave me a link below, which is an affiliate link. So if you click that, it supports the channel, but it's free. Unless you want to go for the pro version to get a little more tools and stuff. But see how already the quality is just so much better, and it's really easy to do this and use your phone as a webcam. The other thing that's like kind of cool about it too is that if I take my phone off the holder, so now if I take it off and I want to show my students what I've written, I can come through and show them here what I did for notes, how they should be taking notes, because you know students aren't really wanting to listen nowadays, according to my 11-year-old niece. And that's how you do it. That is option one, which I love, which is great for using all the things. And now we're gonna look to option two, is if you actually want a webcam. Now, in the spirit of full disclosure, I don't own a webcam. I haven't used an external webcam because for me, webcams still are way behind lots of other video technology. However, there is one webcam that I have seen come up over and over and over again as being the best option for what's out there in the market, and that is the Logitech Brio webcam. I've never used it. However, I did recently have a chat with one of my good friends here on YouTube, Peggy from the Pigeon Letter. I did an interview for her and her flock, and one of the things that came up naturally in our conversation was talking about her webcam.
I don't know if this is gonna pick up very well at the recording, but I was showing her that this is what my computer webcam looks like. So you can see I don't have foundation on. The lighting in here is so bad because I didn't set it up. This is my truth. And then I just happen to have a really generous webcam that makes, for some reason, the lighting evens out my face somehow. And I'm like, cool, I don't look red and splotchy at all.
As you can see, there's quite a difference between her native webcam and the Logitech Brio. It looks like it has some skin softening and really good dynamic range. So this might be a really good option for you if you're interested in just having a plug and play situation that's a little more elevated than your webcam. Now the Logitech Brio comes in at $199. However, you might be able to find it on eBay. Let me just see. Let's just see if we can find it cheaper on eBay. That's like kind of my favorite game. Ooh, 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 ooh. Let's see, eBay. Logitech Brio. All right, so here's a used one from $186. Let's go over here and go to filters and condition used. Usually eBay is pretty great for finding things a little bit less. And for things like this, getting it used is a great way to go. However, I have a sneaking suspicion that because it's been so in demand, this whole needing a webcam situation, there isn't really a lot that we're seeing in terms of a discount. So you can save $20, which is nothing to sneeze at. That's such a weird expression. Nothing to sneeze at. As if we sneeze at things, like as we scoff, like achoo. I digress. What am I saying? $199. All that said, if you have about $200 and you want something that's simple, just attaches to your computer, you can take with you anywhere, this is a great option for you. Are you ready for the big guns? I'll share with you the secret trick to getting your webcam looking super attractive, super just, oh, beautiful, where you go into a Zoom room, and this is what happens to me all the time, people kind of go, what? What's going on with you? Why is that background so soft and buttery? Well, it's not cheap, but it's definitely doable. What I'm just gonna say straight out of the gate is if you don't have a camera already, it may not be worth it to you unless you plan to really use that camera. But for a lot of people who have DSLR cameras or a GoPro or something like that, you can buy a little thing, a little chunche that I'm gonna show you, and you can connect it and use that as a webcam. And this is why, if you look at the background, you can see it's like focusing on me, because it's on automatic focus and it's something I can adjust how blurry the background is. And this is one of those things that people really love, because it tells us that something is high quality. So let me do that now. If I'm in focus, look at how blurry and buttery that background is, right? And that's just because I'm using a camera that has a lens that has what's called shallow depth of field, which means it's gonna be blurry back there. And I'm using that as my webcam. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. First, let me show you what this setup looks like. I have my camera right in here in front of my laptop pointed at me, and I can adjust it, all that jazz. The one thing about this is you have to be careful about where your computer is. So like if I have my computer straight up, you see the base of my computer in the frame. So I actually have it tilted back so that I can have everything around where I am. And I like to stand up. I'm a little bit moving and grooving all the time. So I like to stand up, and then I just have a riser. Let me show you this. I have a laptop stand. I'll have it linked below if you're interested in this specifically. But I have this laptop stand, so it's around eye level. But then because I know I'm looking at the camera, I have it angled back so that you can see me clearly. So how do we make this happen? There are a couple things that you need. One is the magic component. It's called a capture card. What this does is it allows your camera to be connected to your computer and to use your camera as if it's a webcam. Now, if you don't have this and you just try to plug your camera into your computer, a lot of times that won't work, and apps like Zoom won't recognize it as a webcam. So you need a capture card. One I have is called a Cam Link, and this is more on the expensive side. There are other ones that are cheaper that I've seen reviews on, and I'll have those linked below, that should work just as well. Then you need an HDMI cord, and you'll be able to look up, if you go to Cam Link, you can see which cameras they're compatible with. Look up, make sure yours is one of them. And then you find the right cord, whether it's a mini HDMI or a full HDMI, find that cord. So you can see mine is very long, so it's still wrapped up. That's gonna be the cord that enables the camera to talk to the capture card. Then the capture card plugs into your computer, and suddenly you have this option when you go to Zoom, where we go from this internal webcam to Cam Link. And then I have this beautiful quality. Now, I feel like the cheapest way you could swing it, if you don't already have a camera, is to go with a GoPro. And you have to check on the website to make sure which ones are compatible, but I believe the new GoPro 9 is around $400. That will plug in beautifully and have really great quality. However, it doesn't need to be the latest version. You can go on eBay and find one for significantly less, plug that in, set it up on a tripod, and then have better quality immediately. And I think it has autofocus too, because that's one of the things that I like, is I can come back here, which I've done before, is I talk about this little light, which is great because it's on a dimmer. If I was just using an innate bulb, it would be this, which is like way too bright, but I can dim it down so it's right at that perfect spot. So I can do this and you can see me. You can see that my portfolio says Gia, all this kind of stuff. But then if I walk back closer, it focuses on me. Having this high quality camera set up as your webcam is really great, especially if you know that you're gonna be spending a lot of time. And it might be worth considering in terms of an investment, because as far as I know, the situation that we're in, needing to be more virtual than not, isn't really changing all that soon. Figuring out a way, given these three options, to level up your video quality is something that can really be helpful and really give you that kind of, I mean, this is my favorite thing about it, is it gives you that elevated sense that you're professional, you have your life together, all of that kind of stuff that's really helpful when you show up. For example, I just did a virtual summit where I was talking to people how to look good and feel confident on Zoom. And because I have my high quality camera plugged in, they immediately trust me, immediately know I can help them because I'm showing up with this kind of superior quality. So something to think about, something to think about. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more content about how to look good, feel confident on video, possibly start a YouTube channel, I don't know, all those things in there, make sure to use the button below and subscribe. And you know, I'm gonna say it, all of this stuff, me showing you how to look good and feel confident, is really more about the confidence than anything else. If people are out there judging you, having their own opinions about this, this, and that, they're not your people anyways. This is about you being able to show up as your best self and not have to worry about other things. Like I think about as a kid, we didn't have a lot of money. And I remember that certain days, more of my attention would be on my clothes because I would be worried, do I have a hole in my armpit or something like that? And what it did is it siphoned energy from me focusing on the things I should really be focusing about. That's why I love giving you these tips and tools and strategies and things, is because it allows you to free your mental space. So you don't have to be worrying about whether or not you look good. You don't need to be worrying about whether your video quality is enough. You can just focus on that sparkly, shiny amazingness that is you and your superpower area that you have to bring to the table, because everybody has one. And I'm confident that yours is amazing. Even if you don't recognize it, you'll get there. I trust in you. I love you. You're amazing. And if you're feeling like learning a little bit more, feel free to check out these videos here. I'll see you next week. Bye.